The Witch of Wookey Hole. It was a bright day to be crouched like this, in between actual rock and an actual hard place. The morning had been so soft and promising, and yet life has a surprise for everyone, any number of them, and they arrive at any time. She had been admiring the courge plant in her garden, how casually it spread its wide dominion over its vertical rivals, carrots, oyster root, and poor, struggling celery. She had no second sight, no first sight, really, just that sudden looming shadow blocking the enjoyable sun. Straw-headed, thin-lipped, Father Bernard. There are certain facial expressions that bring a soul straight to her feet, and from there directly into a deep, dark cave. A short history of this good lady. Old Ma Meredith is a favourite of the area, most relied upon for treatment and advice, a prolific bringer of babies into the world, other people's mainly, a fair amount personally too, of these all female dotted about the West Country, above and below ground. She found she said less as she aged, a lovely relief. She had spent many years trying and pleasing, and as she reached a pleasant and robust, well-earned and unusual seventh decade, she wrapped herself up in her experience and age and really listened. She is all eyes and ears these days. She finds eyes fascinating and has learnt to talk with them and also to process a million stories too. An example. 5 years previous to this, in a split second, she could see Bernard and Meave, the growing imbalance, how Bernard's looks towards Meave could strip a willow, how her gaze wandered. It's difficult sometimes to be red like this, to feel naked, and Bernard's hackles rise when Ma Meredith's clever gaze rests on him. When the inevitable arrives and Meave takes her apologetic and pitying leave from his life, firmly on the arm of another, milder man, Bernard is overwhelmed by feeling. With few avenues of expression, he chooses easy, predictable anger and points his finger at shrewd Mother Meredith. It's quite a feat to turn so many against so small and trusted a figure. Many are not turned, of course, but life is so full of troubles, and it is so satisfying to pin them on others, like a tail on a donkey, and when there is a nice fit, blights, failed crops, flooding, money, always money. Scandal too is seductive, and he is not above suggesting that she likes to play cock to the hen. No one likes a vengeful monk. It's not a good look, is it? But Bernard is so tied up with knots inside, and he imagines Ma Meredith tying knots, murmuring incantations, knots on the bedpost, knots in her kerchief, knots around her willow tree. He has turned his back on love, taken the name Father Bernard, trying to give his heart to Jesus, but it is squeezed inside his chest and he can be father to nobody. He needs rest. Why do some people think that rest can be found with destruction? It is confused with oblivion, I suppose. So rather than boiling in a cauldron or being cut into quarters or any other of these perfectly lawful acts, poor Ma Meredith runs into the caves, and in the dripping darkness you would think that this woman would be petrified. And yet, here she crouches. Crone's pose, could you call it? Jammed in, pointy hat to pointy heel. And again she listens, and she looks. And she has big sleeves full of spells, and she can certainly cook them up in this here cave. Certainly give Father Bernard a run for his shilling. Full of power, brave of heart, open in all the ways you must be to truly love. She is a resourceful witch, and she has found a nice, cold, damp, gloomy cave, and she sits in it, and she sits in it. And if you wait long enough, the old fiend himself will appear.